Pretty sweet shoes, too.
Alright, so the ones that don't match or the navy?
Put them both on first. Put them together.
You got a little tail
now. If I take the vest off.
What are you going to take the vest off for? You're not taking the vest off, let's just be honest.
No?
Okay. So am I going to go with the navy? Does the navy look good like this?
Yeah, I think it does.
Alright, I'm going to go with the navy. You're going to pull one like this. You see the difference?
Where do I start the thing?
What size neck do you have?
17 and a half.
Okay, put it through the 17 and a half. And then, yeah, inside. Here, it's probably easier, wait, especially for you, to put this underneath first. Yeah! Then we take it, throw this over, hold on, wait. Now get through over top. Okay? No, I'm sorry. We tie first.
Oh. They haven't left the house yet at all. Alright, so I'm running back real quick. You guys can just, do you know where the Roebling Bridge parking lot is?
First and B's too.
Okay, just stay there. We'll meet you there, and I'm running back, and then I'll head straight back. Alright, bye. We freaking, Troy forgot Ashley's letter that I told him, and he needed to bring.
You did not say the pictures.
Yeah, it's one heck of a best man right now.
Oh, that's a shot.
What can you do? We got time. Ashley's not in her dress yet either, so it's another 45 minutes later. Sappy up in here. Ashley, I write you this hoping to show you through words how I feel on this day that we'll never forget. I have so many feelings running through my head right now. Happy, surreal, thankful, joy, peace, comfort, and love. 1 Corinthians 13:13 says, "And now those three remain, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love. I have faith in Jesus that he has done the work on the cross for our sins and that he rose 3 days later. Without this, we don't have a foundation to lay our marriage on. I have hope in our marriage and that we have our roots deep in Jesus that we cannot come, that we can overcome anything that is in our way with Jesus. I also have hope in you that you would become even more loving, caring, and compassionate than what you already are. considering who you're marrying, I need it. But the greatest of these is love. And love will never fail. A love that will never fail, Jesus. Babe, I pray that I can love you by loving Jesus. I will fail, but I will never stop loving you. You are my best friend, my soon-to-be spouse, and my accountability to Jesus.
Brandon, I'm really not sure where to begin. My heart is so filled with so many emotions. Joy, thankfulness, fear, anxiety, excitement. It's hard to pick just one. But then again, on a day like today, it's hard not to pick one. Babe, we are getting married today. How crazy is that? I'm so thankful that I'm able to write this letter and read it to you before I see you, because once I see you, I'm sure I'll have no words. Brandon, you're my best friend, and I couldn't imagine starting this journey of marriage with anyone else. You're so very dear to me that it sometimes doesn't seem real. I can't put into words how much you mean to me, how excited I am to love you until hopefully we are both old and gray. I used loving me like Jesus, for being there always, and for loving my family as well as loving me. I can't wait to be your wife and to be able to call you my husband. Thank you again for just who you are, because I love you so much.
You coming over here or am I coming over there? Okay. I thought that was the end.
Today we take that first step of marriage with family and friends around us who love us more than we'll ever know. In the eyes of our Savior who loves us more than we could ever dream. Just remember, He is the original blessing. And today is just another blessing He chooses to give us. Praise Jesus, He's so good. I couldn't be more thankful. So in closing, I'm Morgan Freeman, love you to the back. I can't wait to start our lives together. And by the way, happy 2-year anniversary of dating and soon to be 1-day anniversary of being married. I love you.
Best man speech right there.
That's how I am with my pillow pet.
Yeah, rolling.
action. As I said, Brandon, why Ashley?
Why Ashley? I think that Ashley is obviously to me one of the most gorgeous people there is.
I look, so I look in there at you.
Either one, it doesn't matter. Yeah.
Probably just because I think I said it in my letter, out of all the people, he's the one that continued to pursue me even though there were times that I backed off. He never stopped loving me more than anybody else that I've ever met. And so in his heart for Jesus is definitely one of the cooler things about him.
Sovereignly bringing them together and growing them in love for one another. We thank you for using their families to prepare them for this glorious day. Thank you for the good times and for the trials and difficulties that have been all a part of your sovereign plan to mold them and shape them to be husband and wife. Our prayer is that now together, as one, their love for Christ will always reign stronger than their love for one another. Oh Lord, shine your glory through this young couple, and use them as both your divine instruments and your trophies of grace. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Because many times we say things, and sometimes we listen, and sometimes they just bounce right off of you. Like many times it may take a lot of words to convince somebody not to wear snakeskin boots to the wedding rehearsal. But the hardest part, though, when you listen, is living those words out day by day. So as we say our words today, make sure that we realize that tomorrow you're going to have to live out these words with sacrificial actions and choices. So what we're doing right now is the culmination of a lot of work. Preparing for the wedding is hard work. The rehearsal dinner, ceremony, all the details, the reception. But what you'll start doing when you wake up tomorrow morning is when the real work begins. You'll be working on a marriage, and that's a lot harder, especially one that looks to glorify God. So how do you know what a God-glorifying marriage looks like? Well, the book of Genesis gives us the first picture. In Genesis chapter 2, God teaches us that a man and a woman are supposed to leave, cleave, and weave a life together. Genesis 2:24, therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And one flesh is just not physical. Oh no. Oh no. Everything that was in you as an individual person is going to change. In a very real sense, you guys are not just participating in a wedding today, but also in a funeral. The selfishness, the self-centeredness of Brandon is going to have to die. The selfishness and the self-centeredness of Ashley is going to have to die. God is going to create something new out of this death. It'll be your new life together. And as you lay down your lives, you'll find them in a whole new way again in marriage. There's two spools of thread about to hit the weaver's loom. God is the weaver. You guys are the thread. He's going to start weaving a new creation, something original, something that's never been seen before, something that's bigger and better than anybody could have even imagined. That tapestry that will put on display the gospel and the glory of Lord Jesus Christ. You see, the high calling of marriage is to flesh out the goodness and love of Christ by the way you relate to each other, serve each other, and prefer each other. Brandon and Ashley, what an exciting adventure to think that your marriage is going to be a living portrait of the Lord Jesus Christ and his bride. So the name and the reputation of your two families is not the only thing at stake here. The name and reputation of the Lord Jesus Christ is also riding on this marriage. So Brandon, here's the bottom line for you. Because many times as we get married, we just want to know, well, what's this thing all about? Here's your charge. If we want to glorify God through our marriage, this is what we're going to be doing. You're to be a visible demonstration of the sacrificial love of Jesus Christ for his bride, the church. You will show by the way you treat Ashley and the way that you lay down your life for her, when people watch the way you love Ashley, it should cause them to think about Jesus Christ. Ashley, here's the bottom line for you. You're to be a visible demonstration of what it means to joyfully respond to, submit to, and follow the loving leadership and care of your husband, Brandon, just like the church. One allegiance will belong to the Lord Jesus Christ, and forsaking all others, your first earthly love will belong to your new wife, Ashley. He said, I do. Ashley, you promise before God, before me, his minister, and before these, your loved ones and friends, that for the rest of your life, your number one allegiance will belong to the Lord Jesus Christ. And forsaking all others, your first earthly love will belong to your husband's brother. Small one. Brandon, please take Ashley's left hand. This ring. Repeat after me. This ring.
This ring
is a picture of my commitment.
It's a picture of my commitment
and love for you.
I give it to you.
To wear and enjoy.
To wear and enjoy.
And I give it in humble gratitude.
And I give it in humble gratitude.
That the Lord Jesus Christ led us together.
The Lord Jesus Christ led us together.
Ashley, this ring.
This ring
is a picture of my commitment.
Is a picture of my commitment
and love for you.
I give it to you.
To wear and enjoy. And I give it in humble gratitude that the Lord Jesus Christ led us together. by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel, and in conformity with the laws of this state, pronounce you as husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Brandon, you may kiss your bride. It is my privilege now to introduce, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Brandon Catchen.